Yeah, going straight into a second topic. Unajua vile watu wako na tabia mbaya sana ya kupitia simu za watu. And let me ask, eh?
Yes.
Would you go through your wife's phone?
Have you ever gone through your wife's phone?
In the beginning, when I bought a phone, and you see now the kind of the work I'm doing with all the people, the ladies and the men. So you could find that maybe a lady is calling you at night. You know, this is a client. She's calling you at night. And now when she picks the phone, it's a lady who is speaking. You know, there were a lot of confrontation. So we had to sit down and discuss and tell her, please, just let me deal with my phone and deal your phone. Okay? Because even us, she has people who are calling them who are men. But you see, I could have, okay, for me I understood, but for her she couldn't understand. But until we came down, we sat down and say, no, please, let everybody handle his or her phone.
We were in a relationship.
Yeah.
Umeshapitia phone ya your significant other?
Of course.
Regularly.
Mpaka saa hizi bado unapitia?
Yeah. When he comes, he gives it to me.
Pitia, confirm.
Then I have to go through the same. Same to him. He also goes through mine.
Yani mkifika tu kwa the first time na same scene.
Atafika hivi.
Shika. Hai. Nasi hata delete ile hata kiuone.
Kwa nini unashake kichwa?
Is that a collision game? What I'm stating, you know, let me tell you, if you're disciplined, let me tell you one thing, you're just a discipline, because we always suspect everything, guys, and let me say one thing, I'm very free with my phone, I don't put locks in my phones, because me, I deal with clients, I deal with medical facilities and all that, sales, so we meet, there are some jokes maybe you normally make in town, but you're never serious, are you getting?
What kind of jokes?
Jokes, okay, when you're in your office. And for example, I say, Miriam, you're beautiful. That doesn't mean I'd have anything concerning.
That's a joke.
That's a joke.
Yeah. You want to joke for simu yake.
Hey, these are jokes.
I'm going to say, hey, he just won't be smart. I love to make up jokes.
Let me say something on that. Okay, I have a message that was sent to me by a lady I'm working with.
Please read it.
Let me just read it. Yes. It's a joke. The way she said it.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is what it reads. I need to ask you something, and please be totally honest with me. It may be awkward. Sorry. It may be awkward between us after this, but I have to know. I have kept it in for a while now, but I think it's finally time to be straight up and just confront you. I hope this doesn't ruin our friendship. I just need to know, and I didn't see any other way I could get over this. It just doesn't seem fair on me if I don't get an answer. Tell me truthfully, please. No matter how harsh it is, I just want to your honest opinion. Why have unga prices gone up? Have a good day.
Sasa, wacha nikwambie. Wife asome, ajafikia hiyo ya unga prices. Anafikia to all honesty.
Yes, yes. That's why I was telling you, this is a joke. In fact, when I was reading it before you got there, I wondered I kept on asking, why? Anataka kuuliza nini? But you see, no, at the end you find that it's just a joke. And I could SMS to a few friends of mine. Ladies. Now, if my wife gets this kind of a message,
yeah,
it's trouble. That's why I decided in my family that let us have respect on one's phone.
Hii nadiru na wanaume. Hata yeye anadiru na biashara yake ni ya wanawake. Sasa tukifanya hivyo tutadivorce.
Na sasa wewe umeenda kuangalia ni saa ngapi? SMS imeingia. Alafu imeandikwa.
My from friend, Twitter.
Nasi namba yako.
No, you don't need to read that message actually. Yes, using my wife's phone, I normally use it. Nachukua kama sina credit, I can use it to call somebody. Lakini hata kasaile nataka kupiga mtu apige, and I see maybe it's Martin, it's James. No, give her the phone. Let her answer that phone.
Kuna jamaa ambaye tunafanya kazi na yeye. Na wako na bibi yake. Bibi yake alikuwa anasumbuka sana. Kumbe jamaa ako na mpango wa kando. Baada ya kuandika hali, ameandika money. Sasa yule money akapiga simu. Kwa bahati mbaya ama bahati mzuri, simu ilikuwa na bibi kwa duka. Akaangalia. akashinda huyu mani ni nani, anapiga simu. Akaizima, akakuja akaambia bwanake, bwanake alikuwa ametoka. Kuna mtu amepiga simu anaitwa Mani. Ati Mani, eh. Akaangalia simu, akatoka nje. Pale pale waliweza kukorofana. Ni kwa nini nimekwambia kuna mtu amekupiga simu anaitwa Mani na umetoka? Sasa unaona mambo kama yale yanazaleta shida.
Mungu anachukua lakini siku hizi hiyo na stress. Hiyo anafanya kazi kwa klamu. Hiyo message ni vibaya naona hai. Kaona ni stress sasa hivi siku hangi.
Na yeye yeah, anaangalia.
Hata sijampatia yangu.
Kipo hapo na hapo anaangalia simu yako utafanya nini? Sasa na hakuna mpango ya kando, siwezi muuliza.
Okay, so ukiwa in a relationship, what information do you share with your partner na ni gani iko off limits?
The only thing that we share is that the pin, that is for the phone, nothing else.
Yeah, the M-Pesa.
Pin for my M-Pesa, it's me and mine alone. He's, you see, ATM, nothing.
Majia pesa za mwanaume zinakuanga ya wife na yetu. Zake zinakuanga zake. Yeah. No matter atapata 1 million. Mm. Now you have 10,000.
Atakwambia sasa wewe tutafanya nini? Yeah.
Tutafanya na hiyo nini hiyo pesa?
JB.
Yeah.
Let's see if there's a method to your madness.
There is.
There is.
Yeah. There's a formula.
Check out JB TV. Matatu. Ah, sweetheart, karibu.
Ah, no. Maybe just a glass of water, then I'll take a shower. I've had a long day.
Aya, waraza. Wanawake ni wajanja, ana mimi mmoja wao. Wanawake ni wajanja, ana mimi mmoja wao. Ai, kitayari. Ah, sweetheart, I'm coming. I've missed you so much. Eh, wafikiria mimi sijui kizungu sasa. Ndio maana vizungu mingi kwa hii nyumba siku hizi na chakula kiliwi. Ngoja.
Hi.
Nzuri. Habari yako?
Salama. House number 16?
Eh, ulikuwa unamtafuta nani?
Looking for JB. I had already tested him and
kamwambia niko jiani naja. Ndio wewe sasa? Ndio wewe?
Hivi sasa ndio wewe?
Yes. Na wasema tu ni mama likubwa kama wewe hivi. Ni ndivyo umejipaka kwa mdomo?
What?
Ni mama likubwa hivi hata adabu una? Ndio maana vizungu vinja kwa nyumba. Chakula haviliwi.
Why so rude? Rude utajua wewe. Muangalia umetoka hivi ulikotoka. Ondoa hii hapa.
Madam. Why so rude?
Rude wewe.
Ah. Hey. Oh my boy. Ona taadabu hakuna kwa hii nyumba.
Mom. There's a lady I want to marry.
Jibu mamako. La haula nakusha bibi.
Matatu. Imagine.
Are you serious?
Hata nime change mind, simuoi tena.
Hii ni real life experience,
yeah.
Walala, pole sana.
Like na hata natafuta.
Yeah.
If you're out there and you don't go through people's phones. My number is 0722.
Tuendelee na mada hii.
Kwa kawaida wanaume. Kuongea ukweli, kuna mambo mengi sana wanaume wale. Pasina na bibi zao. Si ni kweli? Wanaume tuko hapa.
Yeah.
Kwa mfano mambo ya pesa. Kama vile huyu mzee amesema. Wanawake ni extravagant.
Not all men that speak the truth of the man that they have. And if these men are no budget the money properly. If I don't say that we normally overspend. So ladies, not all men. 25% speak the truth that I earn this. So please, can you sit down and talk? What are we going to do with this money? 25%
there. But sister, imagine.
75%.
Do you say how much you earn?
The
do you say?
They do not say. I'm telling you, they do not say.
What about you ladies?
What
about ladies? Do you say?
Yeah, some do say, especially if a man is more salary than you. I'll definitely say it out.
For ladies, if you open up your information in relation to money and the developmental projects, you are making your wife or your girlfriend insecure. These ladies believe that the more you get the money, the more you are exposed to other ladies, and they become more and more insecure. So for the sake of the relationship, it's good to have at least 10% or 5% of the whole amount.
Apart from pesa, information on kind of clearly who are to share here for matatu na spouses wao. Na just social networks, kama uko kwa Facebook.
Okay.
Your girlfriend ama your wife ni friend yako on Facebook.
Okay. Personally, mimi siko kwa Facebook all and social networks. At the same time, I believe that information sharing ni crucial for development ya two people together. But to a limit. To a limit. Information about who you are kwa sababu you guys mfikiria mtakuishi pamoja ni sawa. Ni sawa. What you like, your weaknesses for at least ndio asijaka kanyaga line yenye upendi, unaona? Lakini kuna other things yenye ni kurusha sana zitaharibu. So una avoid. Share other the general information, just share it out.
But how do you now safeguard this information and how to kushare?
Your privacy. Yeah. How do you safeguard your privacy in a relationship?
For me, I found that I'm weak on Facebook. I'm very weak.
How?
I'm very weak. Okay, I'm a Christian. When I go to Facebook, you understand the issue of Facebook. People want to be your friends.
Yeah.
And you find that maybe they are ladies, most of them. Now when you add them to the Facebook, other things start developing. So that's why I share to my Facebook. Speak kama ni mimi peke yangu ama ni nini. Because most of the time, anataka umuadi kwa Facebook, tomorrow she's giving you a very funny information. Bakuna shanga, what's happening?
Wewe unalindanga aji privacy yako?
Mimi? Ni, it's very easy. Yeah. Sasa kama, if you, kama ni lazima ukue na mpango wa kando. Eh? Na anaitwa Rachel, unamuita Roba. Akikupigia simu namba, ni aje buda? Sema, sasa tukuenda inje. Please, be sharp. Ukitumia SMS, usienda kwa inbox, inenda kwa tools. Serious. But easy my SMS is there, they are spoiling marriages. Sababu unakaa kwa nyumba, wife wako amepitia simu yako, anaona kumbe una deni ya mtu. Uende kumwambia, ah wewe hata JB na uko na deni ya watu unapiga kelele hapa. So mimi vile nafanya najitumianga every month najitumia SMS. Imeandikwa you have won 1 million with Ponyoka na shindana na promotion. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anaanza ku budget. Even now she thinks I have 10 million.
And you don't.
Yeah, I send every month.
Yeah. Okay, and on that note, we fika mwisho wa matatu. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll be back tomorrow with two hot topics. I'll see you, Jimmy.
Yes, but meanwhile, utupate kwa Facebook, Matatu Sema Kitu, and on Twitter, follow us on Matatu Kenya.
Yes, goodbye for now and God bless you.